As part of F42 Student Labs Android Game Dev Series, here is the video tutorial on the first session. In this tutorial, I will cover how to configure Java, Android SDK setup, create basic tic-tac-toe game in Android, integrating basic leaderboard using F42 services. Now, I will start with the first point, that is installing Java on your system. To install Java on your system, you could download the latest version of Java from java.com. Once Java will be installed on your system, you can find a Java folder in your program files. Now, you need to change the environment variables of your system to set Java path. To do this, right click on the My computer icon, select the properties, go to advanced system setting, select environment variables, system variables. You have to add a variable Java home, which will specify Java home directory. You also need Java JDK bin path in the path system variable. Once it is done, Java is configured on your system. Now, I will move with the second point, that is Android SDK setup on your system. So, to do this, go to developer.android.com and download the latest Android SDK. Once it is downloaded, you would get a zip like this. This zip file contains Eclipse, Android SDK, and SDKManager.exe. The Eclipse that already have a ADT plugin that is used for Android development. If you want manually install ADT in your Eclipse, then open your Eclipse, go to Help, select Install New Software, click on Add. Here is the name, that is ADT, and location. In location, you have to pass the URL of your plugin. Now Android is configured on your system. So we will create a Hello World project. Click on File, New, Projects, Android Application Projects. Specify application name. Here is your test step. To check your Android app output, you need to create an Android virtual device. To create Android virtual device, go to Windows, select Android Virtual Device Manager, New, name your device. And click OK to create device. Once it is created, you need to start your device. Now, to run your test Android app, right click on the project, run as Android application. Here is the output of your Android Hello World application. Here you can see the directory structure of our Android project. So Android project contain source, bin, zni, zen, res, libs folder, and beside this it also has Android manifest XML, project properties, local.properties, end.properties and build.xml file. Where source folder contains the source code of your Android project and res folder contains the resources which is your Android project is using. Libs contain the libraries files. Android manifest.xml file control is a control file that describes the nature of your application and each of its component. To know more about Android, you could visit developer.android.com tools projects index.html. Now I will start with the tic-tac-toe game. Our tic-tac-toe game contains three screens. In Android, a screen is represented by activity. So our tic-tac-toe game has main activity that represents a main screen, game activity which represents a game screen, and leaderboard activity which represents leaderboard screen. You also need to all the activities which you are using in your project to be defined in the Android manifest.xml. So here you can see I have mentioned all the activities that I am using in my project. Now I will start with the main activity. To create the UI of the main activity, I have defined Android layout XML files, which you can find in this layout activity main.xml. Here you can see activity main has a play game button, a leaderboard button, and two images to select your type. You could also check layout XML file of other activities. So activity game has a grid view. Activity leaderboard has a list view. To start tic-tac-toe game, right click on the project, run as Android application. So this is the view of the main activity. So it has play game button, leaderboard button, and two images to select your type. If user click on the play game button, it first asks to select your type. Now I'll move to the main activity.java code. once user click on play button, play game clicked is called, which I have already specified in layout.xml. So it first check user have selected its type or not. If not, then it shows a toast message to user. And if yes, then it move to the game activity. Once you will be on game activity, the game is started. You need to tap on the screen to complete your turn. Once you complete your turn, computer move his turn. To check leaderboard, click on leaderboard. It will show to the list of the users who played the game. To submit your score, you need to finish the game within 60 seconds. Once your score will be submitted, you can check your name in the leaderboard. All the game related logic is written in the gameactivity.java. Here I have used the concept of 2D array. Leaderboard activity is basically to show a list representation of the users who submitted their scores. To maintain leaderboard, I have used F42 scoreboard services. All the handling is done in F42handler.java. Once you will be registered to a Apache console, you could get your API key and secret key. You need to create your game. So to submit your score, you need to call scoreboard service that save user score. And to get leaderboard, you need to call scoreboard service dot get top end rankers. So this is all explanation about the tic-tac-toe game in Android and integrating F42 leaderboard.